Sorry. Roulette pit was a zoo tonight. Two Asians got drunk. One of them tried to urinate
on me. Let's get out of here.
Doris, I just arrived. I picked this place because it's deserted. You know, we can think. This is our future we're talking about now. Sweetheart, I don't mean to pressure you, but the Caesars people have offered me a roulette pit of my own in Atlantic City. That's a big break. And tomorrow's my deadline for telling them yes or no, so you gotta tell me tonight. Will you come with me?
That's not what you mean when you say come with me. You mean come live with me, then love me, then marry me?
Yes, and have children. Is that so awful?
Come on, Osgood. I've been married 3 times. I suck at it.
You just haven't found...
It's nuts. You and me. Just you and me. Come on.
I wanna dance.
We're talking here. All right?
Let's go. Come on.
Hey. Excuse me.
Let go.
Look, buddy, I don't think you want to make me mad.
I don't care what games you want to play.
That's twice now you've touched her. Don't do it again.
I won't touch her again. Not until she asks me. I got one question. Is it all right if I touch you?
Are you good?
Oh, dear, look at me.
Give me that.
Fucking new.
Give me that. Hey!
All you gotta do is come and get it.
It's mine and I want it. God damn it! Be careful with that!
Come on, let's go. Take me out of here.
That cost a lot of money. I had it made
fuck
special.
Fuck the money, Osgood!
Osgood. No one's got fucking name like Osgood. Jesus.
Bitch.
Come on, please. Oh, I'm scared.
Who the fuck's got a name
you
like
have to
Osgood?
Be scared.
Hey, I can't help that guy.
I could have handled him.
You don't want us?
I know.
Is the house trained?
God damn! I try to behave like a gentleman, Doris. I really do, you know? But there's an animal side to everybody. You think less of me, don't you, for walking out?
Please, how can you even say that? I was the one who dragged you out of there.
I say that because I think it's the truth.
Osgood.
No. Walk me to the car, please.
Come back. Come over here, mate. I brought your hamster back. Ozzy, Wozzy. Osgood.
God damn it! That's enough!
Hey, look. I don't want this no more. I wouldn't know where to feed it.
Osgood, come back! Osgood, please!
Oops.
Move back.
Move back. Why?
Safety precaution, let's say.
I don't need no tricks to deal with a peewee shrimp fag like you. All I need is my hands.
Oscar!
Shut up!
But...
Close your goddamn mouth! Doris, no one's leaving till it's over. And it isn't over till you say it is.
It's over. Help me up, okay?
You know what you are, pal? You're a coward. And your breath stinks. Oh, no, I'm a mess.
You're my own little hero.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas. Christmas tree. They won't mean a thing if you're not here with me. I'll have a blue Christmas, that's certain. And when that blue heartache starts hurting, you'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white. But I have a blue, blue Christmas. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white. But I'll have a blue, blue
in the parking lot. She's in and out. Hands clear.
Can you tell me your name? Do you have any allergies? Tell me who did this to you. Who did this to you? Sweetheart, can you tell me who did this to you?
Thought you'd make it in, huh? Isn't this the 5,000th morning in the Athens of America?
5,000th morning.
How are you surviving?
You know. Not my own.
Yeah, it looks like it.
I'm not up to it, Pinky. Read it to me.
All right. Let the games begin. How about, Mr. Wilde, how can I become a mercenary like you? If someone were hypothetically interested in creating a small explosion, how would one hypothetically research such a thing without leaving a computer trail? Thanks. P.S. This is research for a hypothetical screenplay. Hypothetically, I wouldn't answer this guy.
Great advice, Pinky.
Oh, good morning. Pink is Zion, attorney at law. How can I help you?
Cyrus Kinnick, looking for Nick Wilde.
He's right behind you. Nick, this is Cyrus Kinnick.
Thank you. Hello, Mr. Wilde. I was thinking of hitting the casino tonight.
I wish I could help you, pal. You gotta be 21. They'll lose the license.
I'm 23 years old, but my youthful appearance is one of the reasons why I believe I need a bodyguard. May I be frank?
Grab a seat.
Looked you up on an online guide to Vegas, but you weren't in it. That bothers me. See, I'm a considerable gambler. That isn't being too boastful, and safety means much to me. I checked under every synonym for safety, but there was no Nick Wilde.
Well, you should have tried between chapels and charm schools. I don't want to be too boastful either, Mr. Kinnick, but you're talking to the only chaperone in all of Nevada.
I see, now I'm confused. I was referred to you by an ex-client who was a neighbor of mine in Boston. I simply took him off his advice, but now I fear you may be too jocular. Could you tell me about yourself?
You mean, you want my qualifications?
Along those lines.
Along those lines. Well, I've been knocked down, blown up, lied to, shit on, and shot at. So nothing surprises me much anymore, except the things that people do to each other. I'm a licensed pilot. Took karate in Tokyo. Lectured on economics at Yale. I can memorize the front pages of the New York Times in 5 minutes and repeat it back to you in 5 weeks. I was National Golden Gloves champion 3 years in a row. I'm fluent in 4 languages and can wrestle with a menu in 5 more.
Jesus.
And don't interrupt me. There's more.
More?
Yeah. I'll lie a lot.
I'm staying at Caesar's, Mr. Wilde. Shall we say 7 o'clock?
7 o'clock, Mr. Kinnick. You'd be such a bastard, Oz, huh? Said I was a coward and my breath was bad. That's not an insult, that's a fucking insult.
I was in character, man. I'm fucking around. You're too sensitive. And you didn't tell me you were gonna take my fucking hair. What was that, man?
She likes you better without it.
Yeah. Women, they like honesty. Who knew?
Word to the wise.
All right. Fresh from the bank, $1,000.
That's not the right amount.
Are you calling me a crook? Because I am not a crook.
Nobody said you were.
You forgot the bonus, Nikki. I said if she came along out of pressure I was putting on, fine. Whatever. Done. But if by seeing the real me, they could bring out that she loved me, there'd be $500 bonus. $1,000.
And that's what happened. She saw the real you.
She fucking loves me, man. Love.
I'll take the 500, Oz.
Steak keeps getting better and better. I love you, man. I mean, I love you. Yeah! Hey, I'm gonna write you from Atlantic City.
Ooh, it's where we're all headed. How you doing, Nick?
Oh, great, Rux. Except for
what it is. So,
I put the gas and everyone tables you like you asked.
I bet you give it a room with a busted toilet.
Oh, yeah. I like that one.
I'm not wearing a ring. You wouldn't have known me. I stay with her on account of our 4 kids and I can survive. Except when fate threw a toilet at my flesh. Brings me in contact with a special specimen like you.
Yes. What I miss?
The special specimen.
Fuck.
Shh. It's about to ask for a memory.
Okay, she's dead, but she won't lie down.
Oh, she'll lie down. She just doesn't realize it's going to happen in 5 minutes.
I can get a key to $1,000 suite. So please, Mary, leave me with a memory. Give me something I can cherish to remember.
Okay.
Thank you. Come on.
Son of a bitch. How does he get fucked every time? What is that?
Hey, he wants you that much.
Well, I don't have anything like that. Do you?
Sure. Never ever to rest my head on the same pillow twice.
Well, travel costs.
Tell me. I need $500,000 to buy me 5 years. Right now, I'm only short $499,500.
Well, luck will find you, Nick.
I know. When it does, I'll grab the fucker by the throat.
Just called. So if you're not finished with your grapefruit juice, don't waste it.
It's open. Want some coffee?
No.
I just brewed it. It's 100% Colombian. It's right there on the table.
Holly, if you're gonna hide, why couldn't we have just talked on the phone?
I just don't think I want you seeing me like this. You know, I kept calling out for you in emergency. The doctor says I kept saying Nick over and over again. I thought that you were the one who...
They did.
I don't know. That's why I phoned you. So I had a date last night. When I left, I got to the elevator and the doors were opening, but it was going up. And there were three guys inside. The young guy was the boss. He was built real strong, like a fighter. The two big guys were his flunkies. And the fighter says, "Come on to the party." And I said I was tired, and he said, "Hey, I'm too pretty to turn down." And he pulled me inside, and we get to his suite. And I said, "Where's the party?" And he says, "You're it." And he signals for the big guys to go into the next room. And he says, "Aren't you the lucky bitch? You're the only girl in the world tonight that gets to touch it." And he looks down at himself. Says, "The envy of all mankind." Well, he did what he did. And the big guys worked me over real good on the service stairs. And some hotel people, they dumped me at emergency. Isn't 100 what you charge for the first hour?
Today's my day for turning down money. What do you want to pay me for?
Because I want to sue his ass, Nikki.
You must hire a lawyer, Holly. I'm not a lawyer.
Well, I don't even know his name or what room he was in or any goddamn thing about him.
Then you must hire a detective, Holly. I'm not a detective.
I don't know any goddamn detectives, Nick. I know you. And you know everybody. I mean, how could you not help me?
Because I'm going to guess the three gentlemen you talked about were not IBM executives. What hotel were you in?
Golden Nugget.
Better and better.
A lot of people like it.
True. And so is this. Every high school student knows there's no such thing as organized crime in America. Every elementary school student knows that if organized crime ever dreamt of invading, the last city they would come to would be Vegas. And every kindergarten student knows that if the mob ever did come to town, the last hotel to be tainted would be the Golden Nugget. Shit, Holly. I mean, even the fucking showgirls can rip the phone book in half. I mean, I told you not to go out of that place. You know what? You can always piss me off, Holly. I'm leaving now. I want us to be clear. Holly, when I came to this town, you were just a kid who lived across the street. The first year, Baby himself tried to recruit me for his organization. I said, no. If someone got bloody, I wanted it to be for my reasons, not anybody else's. Baby accepted that. Since then, I've stayed away from them, and they stayed away from me. I don't know a soul that works at the Golden Nugget. I don't have one contact there. I swear to God.
They much appreciate us having visitors.
Hey, listen, I'm interested in a guy. He looks like a fighter. Has a suite, I guess, on a high floor. Travels with two large bodyguards.
You still live in Naked City? You know Big Daddy's?
Of course.
I get off at 4. You come down there about 4:15. If I ain't there, I couldn't find nothing. If I am, we'll talk. Hey, Nick.
Hey, Millicent.
Too bad you got all that British blood in you. If you was black, I'd bet you good and fast.
I can make believe.
Nah. Don't think this is racial or anything, but I never feel like you people are clean. This is a housekeeper you're talking to, remember? I can tell if a Brit's been in a room just like that.
Why should I think that was racial or anything?
Glad you don't. Now, this fighter guy, his name is Danny DeMarco, Suite 3506. He's from a fine old Italian family back east. He's a son and heir, and his daddy loves him, which is why he never goes no place without them two big mothers.
How big are they?
A lot bigger than you. You did me something once. I will owe you forever. But now, I need you to do me something. Do not fuck with these guys. Pickle.
Lady in housekeeping. I just met with her. She struck out, Holly. Couldn't find out a thing.
Oh, Nick. Don't lie anymore. You know what he did when he was finished? Put a gun inside me. He said, "You got one shot at breathing. Tell me you love me. And if I believe you, I'll let you go." I said, said, oh God, I love you. I love you so much, I do. And he said, never shit a shitter. And then he pulled the trigger. And I scream. And I hear a click. Some fucking games to play with another human, right, Nikki? And I want to sue him. And you know who he is. And you just let him walk away.
Just know I tried, Holly.
Sure. Liar. Just know this one thing. All those times I told you I cared for you.
Yeah, I know, I know. You were lying.
Wrong. I loved you. Every good thing I ever said was true. And when you hit bottom, who climbed down there and found you? Only me.
Holly.
Made a wrong turn back that way. Oh, I am ready to see the sights.
Follow me, Mr. Kennett.
Bells will be ringing. The glad, glad news. Oh, what a Christmas. Do have the blues. My baby's gone. I have no friend to wish me greeting once again. Choirs will be singing silent night, Christmas carol by candlelight.
I didn't realize these places were so big.
Yeah, the noise bothers people sometimes.
I don't mind the noise.
Golden Gate is much smaller. It's just a short drive down the block.
By all means. Isn't as nice as some of those other places.
That's tourist traps.
How did you get into this line of work? Special forces, am I right? Trains to run around all commando. What were you? SBS, SRR, SAS?
Just this.
Just S. S for special?
S for shut your mouth. It's not something I'm getting into with you. I can take care of things. That's all you need to know. That and running around all commando isn't a preferred military term.
Oh, he's so touchy. Oh, hi. Excuse me. Can you get a Fiji water, please? You knock bottles over, they don't roll away.
Nikki?
Vodka, double. In a square glass, so it doesn't roll away.
Hmm. Well, I am going to hit the craps table.
The $100 tables are back there.
Yeah, but I can make a greater number of smaller bets at the $10 tables.
Sounds like a winning system. I got your back.
Great. I'd like to bet $10 on the shooter, please.
Hey, Nick. Seen you happier.
How wrong you are, Cassandra. This is the highlight of my career. I'm protecting a Fiji drinker.
Here we go.
He bets $10 on a single roll of the dice. What you see on my face is ecstasy.
My shift's starting.
Yo 11, Nestle.
Hey!
Long winner. Winner.
Rolling hot.
And you know who
quits.
Okay. But I intend on gambling for hours.
I don't have hours. And you're safe in the casino, Kinnick. Nobody will mug you in the casino. And outside, they've got these yellow things called taxis. Just grab one and you'll be back at Caesar's. Half a minute. I'm gonna try. Goodbye, Kinnick. Danny DeMarco, he's staying at the Golden Nugget, Suite 3506. Good night, Ollie.
Wait.
Why?
Please let me write it down.
Then write it down.
Do you know how to spell it?
No.
What'd you say?
That's what I said. Good luck with your fucking lawsuit, okay?
What are you so angry about?
Liar.
I'm not.
You never once intended suing us, son of a bitch, did you, sweetness?
You'll see.
I won't help you anymore. I don't have bias.
Quit calling me that.
Quit doing it then.
Would you help me?
What kind of help could I give you? Huh?
You know.
Yeah, then get killed.
There's only three of them.
Three of them with guns.
You gotta go in there and you gotta soften them up so I can have my chance.
Chance for what, Holly?
I want his nuts in my hands.
And if they kill me?
I'll be miserable for days. I want him so bad for what he did to me. I want my revenge, Nikki.
Mr. DeMarco.
About?
It's personal.
Well, he's busy.
I don't think baby is gonna be too happy with me stuck out here.
I don't give a shit.
Who was it?
It was some guy. Said he was a friend of baby's.
Shit.
So you're a friend of baby's? What's this about?
Go.
You two, get the fuck out. Hey, are you kidding me?
Searched him?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
You checked the hat? Sorry about that, Santa Claus. Can't be too careful these days. We should have a drink. Any friend of babies?
It's good of you to see me like this, Mr. DeMarco.
Danny. Call me Danny. What do I call you?
Nick.
Well, Nick, I'm told there's something about a girl. Where is she?
In my sled on the roof.
Oh. She pretty?
Was.
Come again?
Last night, a friend of mine was just some disrespect, and I thought, you know, maybe he might do something to make things okay.
Oh, that. But you see, Nick, that wasn't disrespect. That was a game. We were having ourselves a little party.
And what happened after wasn't so nice either. She had to be stitched up in emergency.
Oh.
Could he be talking about us?
No, that's not us.
No, not us, boss.
You're lying, Nick.
I know, this is probably another game you're playing, only this time it's with me.
You can't show disrespect to a whore. That's what your friend is.
No, she's a...
It's best not to interrupt me, Nick.
Yes, sir.
She's a whore, you're her pimp. At least you look like a two-bit pimp to me, am I right?
No, I'm legit, Mr. DeMarco.
Look, see? Credit cards. Driver's license, they're all mine.
Well, Nick, what the hell? Maybe you have a point. Would $50,000 cover your disrespect, Nick?
You're very generous.
And you're very stupid. But even so, you probably know what this is. Where it's been.
Let me just leave.
Are you gonna leave, Nick? The question is, what shape you're gonna be in when you do so. Didn't I tell you something about interrupting me, you dumb fuck?
Yes, sir.
You remember what?
You said it was best not to.
Right. You see, if I'm sweet to you, Nick, if I just let you walk out of here free as air, well, I'd want people to know how sweet I am. So, be honest, Nick. Tell me about my good qualities, and if I believe you, well, you're free as air.
You're a great man, Mr. DeMarco, a peach of a guy. You're the best. A genuine top-of-the-line human being.
Mm-hmm. You failed so far, Nick, but I'm gonna give you one more chance. So go ahead. Talk about me. The fuck are you thinking about, huh?
Corsican. But he went away.
Teal, Kinlaw, take this dumb fuck out of my sight. Why don't you show him how sweet I really am?
Let's go.
That's him.
Better be. Or he's got one hell of a lawsuit.
He's sobbing him up pretty good. Remember me?
Sure. You're the party girl we had all those nice games with.
Right. I had so much fun. I can't stand that party's over. I wanted it to go on forever.
Hey, what's she up to, huh?
The envy of all mankind.
Yeah. You know who I am?
Of course. You're the party giver.
What the fuck is she doing, huh? What is this, about money? Is that what this is? Yeah, sure it is. You know what? Just take the 50, huh? Take it for Christ's sake.
What money?
50,000. It's up this drawer.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, see?
This isn't about money. This is about love.
Is it? Hey, I didn't do nothing. It was all Tio and Kinlaw. It was them. Why don't you tell your girl to put those away?
Hope I sharpened these enough. Let's see.
Hey, hey, wait, hey.
Guess they're sharp enough. Look, there's a little tiny cut right on the envy of all mankind.
Oh, let me be, please. I you got the wrong idea. I'm really a good guy. I am.
So you're not mad at me then?
No.
Good. I'm not mad at you either. I'm gonna give you the same break that you gave me. Tommy, you love me. And if I believe it, then I'll let you keep it. But if I don't believe you, that means you're a bad boy. Bad boys need to be punished. So that the envy of all mankind will have to go away with me. What'd you say?
I love you.
I don't think that sounded very sincere. Did it?
Yeah, this is your show.
Don't you please don't.
Last chance.
Oh, I fucking love you. I love you. Please don't. Now, look, I made a little mistake. Everyone can make a little mistake, okay? Just don't. No, please don't. I'm sorry. Alright, it's gone. No.
Wish I brought my camera.
Okay.
You have to leave town, Ollie. You're coming for me, too. First, I'm gonna win enough cash to get out of this place for good.
Yeah, I know. I spent the last hours packing. Without regret, I might add, because I'm heading straight.
Hey, don't tell me. If I don't know, I can't tell anybody.
You guys sure they'll come after you?
You know damn well they will.
You could have killed them.
I try not to do that.
No, you keep it all. You're the one that took the risk. Okay, I want half. I'm the one that took the beating.
A friend of mine left town. We had this kind of gone away thing.
Sounds sweet.
How much longer are you on the shift?
11:50, 10 minutes.
What the hell? I shall keep you company.
I've been killing everyone tonight, Nikki. You did something for me once, so believe this. Bet small. Changing 100.
Since it's a $5 minimum, as if I bet $5.
Blackjack. I lose more friends this way. Hmm. What is it?
Cass, I got 19. And you've got 10 showing. Except I know something. Your down card is another picture, which makes 20, so my 19 is shit.
You want me to hit 19, Nicky?
I'll tell you why. Because there's a weight on my shoulder now. Luck's riding on my shoulder now. It's happened. I've got to go for the throat, Cass. Because of all the people in all the casinos in all the world. Luck's come camping with me. So yes, I want you to hit my 19. And I'd like a 2. 2 is 21. Means I win. Mounting, please, Cass.
Jesus.
Like a $1,000 chip, please, Cass. In one way or another, this is my last night in Vegas.
Changing 1,000.
Up or down? Had luck riding with me. And they changed dealers. Marcel. Not you, me. How do I know it's gone?
Blackjack.
Give me a chip rack, please. Can I raise a limit?
No.
I'll play the whole table then.
Hey, mama, don't you treat me wrong. Come and love you, daddy, all night long.
I'm not greedy. You gotta win sometime.
Blackjack.
What the fuck is this?
Retribution for 5,000 warnings. And what's your mouth? In front of a lady. Thanks, sir. God, what a thing when luck comes calling. Good.
Good. If I win, I'm over 500. And that'll be the last you ever hear of me. Isn't exactly a round number. Then I was never going to quibble.
Fiji?
Vodka. Rocks with a twist.
Look at that. Doubles, please, Veronica.
Thank you, Veronica.
So what do your friends call you?
Cyrus is a pretty shitty name. Always wanted to be called Ace or Duke. Cyrus seems like the overwhelming choice. How are you not more excited?
Never hit over 500,000 before. I don't know why I'm not more excited. Maybe it's because I never did think it would happen. That makes sense?
Kinda.
Anything else?
That's all, thanks, son. Yeah, look, take some time off. Go see your mom.
Thank you so much, Nick.
Cheers.
Hey, cheers.
You're leaving town?
Think bigger. State, country, continent. 5 free years, Duke. Been dreaming of since forever. 100,000 per. Better figure than a penny.
Guess you haven't liked Vegas much, huh?
You're not supposed to like Vegas. It's just this creeping virus people catch sometimes. Sweet dreams. I'm up to Corsica in the morning. I want to sail the Mediterranean before I die.
I'll walk you out.
That's very kind of you, Duke. It's all horseshit. It's just a loser's dream.
I don't get you.
This is not what I need. 5 years would only be fine at first. After that, I just realized that every day was another day closer to being back here. Never pushed the logic because I never thought I'd be in this position. 500,000. And there's nothing. But now I really need.
What's that?
Fuck you, money. Enough so I'll never have to come back here. Freedom. That's what fuck you, money is.
Clear that.
Let me try.
thinks I'm gonna lose.
You've got it.
Also, it's 500. You can't do it.
$500,000 going out.
Send it.
That's $525,000. This fella's getting awful heavy. All on one guess. Just like we started, Cass. I know you've got another picture under there. Hit me. A 4. If you don't mind.
Good, Nikki. You would have won.
I came in with 25,000. Lost 25,000. No big deal.
Would you like your grapefruit juice now?
How did I get here?
After you passed out, I tipped some of the staff to help me bring you.
Thank you.
I thought you'd be thirsty.
Listen, Duke. You're a great caterer, and I appreciate it. But I think you got something to say the first time you said it.
won't laugh?
Not today.
All right, I lied about my friend recommending you. And I didn't have to ask for your qualifications. I knew everything about you. I've researched you. I knew about the grapefruit juice, right? And the double vodka. And I know about why you always sit in the same spot at the Silver Spoon counter. I need something from you, and I've come too far for a no answer. A while back in Boston, I saw this old guy on the street, and he had a sign on his back that said, "Please don't hit me." And my first thought was, what a sad thing. But then I got so fucking mad because I realized that was gonna be me when I got old. Just an old nut scared of the world. And so I've come to you. I want you to teach me.
Teach you what?
Anything. Everything. I need you to kill the fear that lives inside of me every day. You want to sail the Mediterranean, I want to do something brave before I die.
Hey, listen, kid.
I earned $70 million by the time I was 19. Don't call me kid.
Jesus. Yeah.
It's nothing. I put a new twist on an old twist on computer software. Being smarter is the only defense I've ever had, but it's not enough anymore. You've got to help me.
You know fucking where this is? You're not even 30, set for life. I'm pushing 40, broke.
I'll pay you. I'll make you rich.
I have been rich. Most recently last night.
Yeah, I can help you with that too.
Help me with what?
Are you serious?
I like blackjack. Maybe more than I should. That's all.
Why do you think you stay here? You hate it so much, it's the only place you can stay. It's the only place you're worthy of. It's all so obvious.
Well, if it's all so fucking obvious, why are you so fucking wrong? Huh?
Don't go. We can help each other.
You know what? You're just like the nuts who write to me. You want adventure? Swell. Well, I earned my past, Cyrus. Go on your own.
This one's on me, Nick. Looks like you need it.
Nick Wilde, how you doing? You need to come with us, Mr. DeMarco's wing.
Mail days, mail days, mail days. where the treetops glisten and the
over 500 last night at the gate. Talk of the town. Do you remember when was it a couple months ago when you had us beaten for 200 grand? Right here at the Nugget? Till your luck changed.
I'll get us someday.
Nicholas. I'm just in a terrible bind, and it's all because of you. It seems that somebody broke into room 3506 last night, beat up on three guys, and took $50,000.
And that was before I had my Wheaties.
If only that were funny. No, it seems that this same somebody shot and killed two gentlemen named Kinlaw and Teal. Shot them while they were tied and helpless. And an eyewitness claims that that someone was you.
And you believe that?
If I did, you'd be dead. Come along, Nicholas.
Come along where?
To see DeMarco. I have to find the truth.
Wait a minute. You mean I'm on trial?
For your life, I should imagine.
To tell it again. I told you, you believe me, so why?
Because, Daniel, you are asking me to kill Nicholas here. And if a mistake was later discovered, I would feel simply dreadful. So please, be as brief as you will.
I feel guilty because I let him in. When the knock came on the door, I wasn't thinking, and I opened it. And right away, he pistol whips me. Right in the mouth, you see? Right there.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Right there.
Yeah.
And he's quick. He takes out Teal and Kinlaw like they were nothing. And he ties them up back to back the way they were when you found them. And then he rifles my desk. He takes the 50 and for no fucking reason, he goes crazy and he shoots maybe my two best friends in the whole world.
Why?
probably he's pissed that there wasn't more cash, and probably he would have killed me too. But there was a noise out in the hall, and he panicked and he ran. Shot him with their own guns. Baby, can you believe that? You check. You'll see that I'm telling the truth. They're gonna have his fingerprints all over him.
Don't bother checking. The fingerprints are mine.
This is all true then?
Some.
Which? You better speak, Nicholas. And I suggest you begin right now.
I'll ask just two questions, baby. If you can answer them to your satisfaction, do what you will. First, why would I use a gun?
The fuck kind of question is that, huh? Why does anybody use a gun?
Nicholas never does. Believe me, he could kill you with... He could kill you with this. From 5 feet or 15. And the answer to your question is this. It's the perfect cover. Nobody would ever dream that Nick Wilde needed a gun to commit a robbery. All right, Nicholas. Second question. Second and last.
Baby, what do you know about my body? I mean, underneath my clothes.
Obviously nothing.
Well, then here's my second question. How is it possible that I know that Mr. DeMarco here has a small but definite cut on the upper side of his hamstring? Answer? I saw it put there by a dear sweet lady with a pair of garden shears.
What is this shit, huh?
It's easy to find out. If I'm lying, just have him take down his trousers.
You're not buying this crap, are you, baby?
Someone go get a microscope so we can locate Mr. DeMarco's pecker.
You know what? I'm not stripping. I'm not stripping for nobody.
I think you must, Daniel. Nicholas is, risking his life on a very unusual long shot here. I know it's embarrassing, but I'll make it easier for you. You and I will go in the other room. And we'll both take down our pants.
I won't. I won't.
I'm afraid you must.
It's a matter of principle, baby.
Nobody would.
Second cousin.
Principle, eh?
Damn.
It's principle. You, would somebody shut this goddamn fucker up?
Oh, Daniel, you just blew the ball game. Nobody in your family has had even a passing relationship with the principal in the past 50 years.
So you're siding with him. Baby, you believe him over me.
I believe this. I believe that somebody who looks like Nicholas did the deed. And I will endeavor to find him. Now you may go.
You. I'm gonna see you real soon. I'm gonna see you real soon.
Why do you think he did it?
He's a very macho little slime. And he broke down and humiliated himself in front of him.
You know he'll come for you.
Yeah.
If you don't care, why'd you defend yourself?
I didn't want to be remembered for doing what he said. That dying ain't so bad. And at least I'll be out of Las Vegas.
Thank you, Nicholas. Good luck.
Cheers, baby.
All right. Be well.
Thank you.
that bad, huh?
I'm leaving. I'm only here to give you present gratitude of everything you've taught me.
What, for Christ's sakes?
That everyone's afraid? That I'm not the only cowardly asshole in this world. You're one too.
I really needed this now.
What I have to deal with is that I'm the one inside my own skin. Maybe it's not so terrible. And if you could admit what you are, you might find it's not so terrible either.
Okay, Duke. I admit it. If I'd won the full million, I'd have figured some reason to go for more. I'm a trapped compulsive. There. I said it.
See me tap dancing?
No. But you might have taken the first tiny step toward your sailboat.
Yeah, doubtful. Doubtful for two reasons. The first being a lack of funding.
I knew you were going to say that. Reach under the counter. I told you I bought you a present. I taped it there before you got here.
What's this?
One plane ticket to Corsica. And a check for $500,000. So, first reason's taken care of. Now what's the second?
I'm being murdered any minute.
Murdered? Really? When is this happening?
Now.
Find that asshole. I want you to find him. I don't care how long it takes. Any of you dumb fucks.
You call more fucking guys. Get two on the bus station and a few at the airport. Check every bar, every casino, every whorehouse. Turn over every goddamn rock he could slither under. You find out where he lives.
Thank you.
don't want to go back there.
You lost them?
The man who was speaking.
Hey, wait, you forgot these. Take them. No, take them. Nick, please, I can leave town now and know that I'm not a coward. And you have no idea what a relief that is for me. You earned this.
Thanks. But not just for this. Not just for acting like an idiot so I could get out of the diner. You're a good friend.
Friends?
Don't ruin it.
Bye, Duke.
Merry Christmas, Nick.